Let's pray.
Father, thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity we have to honor the students. Thank you so much for this privilege. Father, I'd like to thank you for the school board, for the faculty administration of Town of Penn High School, for their pursuit of excellent education.
I would ask you to be with the commencement exercises today. Thank you, Lord, for the awesome responsibility that is now laid upon these graduates to go forth and to put forth the things that they have learned and put them to good use. Thank you for these parents and grandparents, friends and relatives who have joined together today. May this be a great honor, and may everything we do today honor and glorify your name. We ask this in your precious name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, parents, grandparents, friends and relatives, members of the faculty of Kennedy High School, and members of the class of 1991, good morning to you, and welcome to Allen Park's Municipal Auditorium for Kennedy High School's 26th commencement ceremony. We ask that at the conclusion of today's program that the audience please remain at your seats until the graduates have had an opportunity to exit the auditorium. Our platform guests this morning are, from your left, Ms. Gail Cohn, counselor of Kennedy High School. Mr. Sam Iaquinta, counselor. Mr. Richard Kozik, senior class advisor. Ms. Laura Trent, assistant principal. Mr. Skip Ampazon, treasurer, Board of Education. Mr. Lee Conway, Chairman of Distinguished Alumni Committee. Mr. Richard Trolley, Trustee, Board of Education. Dr. Gordon Lambie, Associate Superintendent of Schools. Mrs. Bethany Iverson, Assistant Superintendent of Instruction. Mr. A. Edward Keckley, President, Board of Education. Mr. Richard Leininger, Deputy Superintendent of Schools. Mr. Roger C. Craig, Superintendent of the Taylor Schools. Mr. Kevin Winningham from the Baptist Park High School. Mr. Robert Harala, Associate Superintendent of Instruction. Mr. Dale Gressinger, Secretary, Board of Education. Mr. Dale Avery, Principal of Titan School. Mr. John Pantalone, Principal at the J.I. Maley Career Center. Mr. Clyde Floyd, Vice President, Board of Education. Mr. Gary Evans, Trustee, Board of Education. Mr. Thomas Polka, Assistant Principal, Kennedy High School. Mr. Charles Kinney, Student Government Advisor. Ms. Joanne Gregg, Counselor, Kennedy High School. And Mr. Fred Tremp, counselor at Kennedy High School. Members of the class of 1991, ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you your superintendent of schools, Mr. Roger C. Craig. Mr. Craig.
Well, you made it. All of you made it. Every single one of you have satisfied all of the requirements of the Taylor School District to graduate and receive your own personal high school diploma with your name on it. You know, we heap a great deal of praise, and it's well-deserved praise, I might add, on our valedictorian and salutatorian, our National Honor Society members, our class leaders, our athletes, our musicians, our cheerleaders, our pom-pom squads, and all the other highly visible leaders of the class of 91, and we're very proud of them. But you know something? What about the rest of the class? Just as sure as there is a number one and number two scholar, there is also a number 239 and a 240. Are they any less deserving of our praise and recognition today? I think not. I think they just might be the real success stories of the class of 91. These are the kids who struggled to get their last half credit, to turn in that extra credit assignment because they were so far behind. They may have attended adult night school to pick up the two extra classes needed to graduate today. These are the kids who worked two jobs and still tried to be a successful full-time high school student. These are the kids who got behind but had enough courage, determination, guts, and self-pride to pull themselves over some of the highest hurdles they have ever found in their young lives. Yes, our valedictorian and salutatorian deserve every cheer and accolade we give them, but so does every other member of the class of 91, because you have proven that you're also made of the right stuff. So stand proud, every last one of you, because you proved to your parents, your teachers, your counselors and principals that you could do it. But more importantly, you proved it to someone far more significant to your future. You proved it to yourself. Now go out and continue to prove your worth in the world of work, college, armed services, or whatever you choose to do, because you're all winners, every last one of you. Congratulations to all the members of the outstanding class of 91. May you all continue to be blessed with success. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Craig. Traditionally, at Kennedy High School's commencement ceremony, we have two of the most outstanding members of the class to deliver the commencement address. And again, this year, that fine tradition continues. Ms. Jennifer Hoffman has been an active member of the Kennedy Concert Band, the Marching Band, and the Pep Band for the past 4 years. She has been a member of the National Honor Society for the past 4 years as well, and has performed with the Henry Ford Metropolitan Youth Symphony. Jennifer has been named Kennedy Musician of the Year for the past 3 years, and this year served as drum major to the marching band. She has been a 3-year member of the Spanish Club, participated in solo ensembles, and was the recipient of the Allen Park Symphony Scholarship last year as a junior. Among her awards and honors are a full tuition scholarship to Wayne State University, Wayne University Talent Scholarship, Wendy International Scholarship, and has been the recipient of the John Philip Sousa Band Award. Jennifer has also been honored by Phi Beta Kappa. Her immediate plans are to attend Wayne State University in the fall, majoring in music performance and music education. Class of 1991, very proud and pleased to present to you your salutatorian, completing her education at Kennedy with a 3.936 grade point average, Ms. Jennifer Hoffman.
An American soldier sitting in a foxhole gazes across a vast expanse of desert. Feeling alone, he asks himself, what will tomorrow bring? Where does my destiny lie? Although he is part of a team, he knows deep down inside that to survive, he must rely on himself, his wits, his knowledge, his intuition, and his skills. He looks back to the past, thinks about where he's been, dreams about going back, but knows he can't. He hopes for the future. He knows that to a great extent, the future is in his hands. At this moment, we're all at a crossroads, perhaps not as dramatic as the soldier in the foxhole, but for each and every one of us, the decisions we make today, tomorrow, and in the future will affect our very lives. We have the tools and the training, just as a soldier in a foxhole. We all have a team behind us, friends, teachers, parents, and God. But again, like the soldier, our success and our survival depends on how we use those tools. There will be people who ridicule us, those who will tell us we aren't capable or lack the intelligence and tenacity to realize our dreams. We must prove to those people that we have the strength, convictions, and skills to succeed. Whatever challenge surfaces in our lives, we must meet it head on and believe and know that we will win the battle. Hold in your heart the people who were always there when you needed them, your support team, and thank them for all they've done. Mom, Dad, Buddy, I love you. Thanks for putting up with my moodiness and sharing in my happiness. Your patience and support made all the difference. Cherish the memories of the activities and clubs that helped shape and give direction to your life. I will forever remember the long days of band camp when we would stand at attention for what seemed to be hours at a time, when we wished that the sun would go down so we could just go to bed, and how we always became dinner for the local swarms of mosquitoes. The band gave me the privilege of being part of something very special, a group of young musicians working together as a team and loving one another as a family, determined to gain respect for themselves and their art. As a last word, I'd like to relate a simple yet powerful message by Louisa May Alcott. Far away there in the sunshine are my highest aspirations. I may not reach them, but I can look up and see their beauty, believe in them, and try to follow where they lead. Class of 1991, good luck.
Thank you, Jennifer. Stacy Carnes has been a four-year member of the Spanish Club and the National Honor Society. She is currently serving as vice president to the Kennedy chapter of NHS. She has participated on Kennedy athletic teams and was selected by the faculty to represent Kennedy High School at Girls State last summer. Stacy is an active member of the Youth in Government Club having participated in those activities in Lansing at the Capitol. Stacy also serves as vice president of that fine organization. Stacy also was selected by the school and the staff to represent Kennedy as a junior Rotarian to the Taylor Rotary Club. She has received many honors and awards, and I would like to share these with you. Stacy had been honored by Phi Beta Kappa and is a recipient of a Phi Beta Kappa scholarship. She is also a recipient of the Madame Curie Award for excellence in mathematics and in science. She has been awarded a Taylor Rotary Scholarship and the Taylor Business and Professional Women's Scholarship as well. She has received the Wayne State University Merit Scholarship, a University of Michigan Regents Alumni Scholarship, and Stacy has decided to attend the University of Michigan in the fall and plans to major in pre-law. Class of 1991, I would like to present to you the number one ranked student in the class with a grade point average of 4.047, the valedictorian, Ms. Stacy Carnes.
Nature's first green is gold, her heart is hue to hold. Her early leaves a flower, but only so an hour. Then leaves subside to leaf, so Eden sank to grief. So dawn goes down to day, nothing gold can stay. As Robert Frost put it, nothing lasts forever. To me, our high school years were a golden time, and now that the time must end, we will say goodbye and go on our separate ways, taking a little piece of each other with us. Remember the strength we gave one another and believe in our ability to achieve. To me, our high school class was like a giant jigsaw puzzle. Alone, we were all just one piece, but as we came together with our aspirations and fears, we formed something special, something I will always cherish, friendships I will never forget, and memories that can never be replaced. I am proud to be a member of Kennedy High School's 25th graduating class. As a class, we worked hard to achieve our own recognition. And as we leave high school with even bigger fears and bigger aspirations, I am confident that we will work even harder to reach the new goals we have set. As I have the honor of being your class valedictorian, I want everyone who ever touched my life, whether it be teachers, counselors, fellow students, friends, or family, to know that you have made this possible, and the honor also belongs to all of you. Because you, as you have touched my life, you have helped make me the person I am today. As we leave here, I'd like to pass on some advice my parents gave to me. They told me to always be true to myself, because you can't have success without happiness. That whatever I wanted from life was out there. All I had to do was work hard and take it. I think it was the best advice I was ever given. Thanks, Mom and Dad. I've always tried to do that. Remember to believe in yourself. And whatever you choose to do, I know you'll be successful. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you, Mr. Kibble, and members of the Kennedy Band. Very, very nicely done. 26 years ago, Kennedy High School held a commencement, our first in the history, and in that class 26 years ago was a young fellow who graduated, just as you people are today. And some of the people on the podium were at that commencement, and I would just like to take a minute to reminisce about that date 26 years ago. Mr. Craig, our superintendent, was the band director. Mr. Leininger was the assistant principal at the school at the time. Mr. Panalone was an assistant principal at Kennedy at the time. I was a counselor back then. Ms. Cohn was teaching English. I think as I look around and indulge with me, Mr. Kozik may have been an English teacher at the time. I think Mr. Trolley was still on the Board of Education 26 years ago. Mr. Lambie was working in the district at the time. Bob Haralo was a math teacher and one of the finest. And as I look around, Mr. Gressinger was, I believe, a principal at the junior high at that time. And Mr. Avery may have been just coming on the scene. And I just wanted to reminisce about these fine people that I've worked with for the past 26 years at Kennedy High School, coming and going. And in that class was a youngster by the name of Lee Conway, who I'd like to introduce to you. Lee left us at that time as an average student and went out into the business world, and through a lot of hard work and perspiration and sacrifice, developed and built what is today one of the largest tire chains in our state, in the Midwest, Tireman Incorporated. And when we began the program of Distinguished Alumni, Lee was one of the first ones inducted to the Distinguished Alumni Program. Here with you this morning to present to you the 1991 inductees from the class of 1966, Mr. Lee Conway. Mr. Conway?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The Taylor Board of Education, the faculty, administration of John F. Kennedy High School, and the Distinguished Alumni Committee are proud to introduce you today to our 1991 inductees. Mary E. Thomas is an alumni from the class of 1969. She is a graduate of Wayne State University. She has spent several years in several management positions at General Motors until the year of 1988. She was recruited by Ford Motor Company, and she is currently holding the position of specialist planner for Ford Motor. Today, we'd like to introduce to you Mary E. Thomas.
John F. Kennedy graduates of the class of 1969, faculty, and honored guests. During my years at Kennedy High School, I was involved in activities that are typical, I suppose. I was involved in the band, debate, and the language club. In my adult life, I have come to believe that everything we experience in life is significant to each of us becoming our own unique individual. For example, the experience that I gained through participation in debate would help me to develop a more global perspective in terms of the views and thoughts of others on a variety of issues. That experience later would influence my attitude toward the real importance of listening to what others have to say. As a member of John F. Kennedy's high school band, the Sensational 77, and the Dynamic 88, as we were known, I learned the value of team participation, for the success of the team and the individuals. My experiences at John F. Kennedy High School culminated as I was promoted through the ranks at General Motors, sought out by a corporate recruiter for Ford Motor Company, and my graduation from Wayne State University. I left Kennedy High School not knowing what my goals in life would be, but I knew this, that it was important to remember the thoughts of other human beings and to learn from them, and the importance of becoming a winner. I wanted to be a winner. Today, I stand before an audience of winners, the graduates of the class of 1991 at Kennedy High School. Some of you are firmly grounded in your short-term or long-term goals. Others are uncertain, as was I. I challenge you today that whatever your course is, that you draw on that experience from your teachers, the faculty, and your parents. No matter how insignificant that experience may seem at the time, build upon it to become that unique individual of decisive choice that will obviously influence the lives of your family, your friends, your community, your workplace, thus the world. I will now leave you with one last thought. Dale Carnegie, author and human relations champion, once said that there are two kinds of people in the world, balcony people and basement people. Be a balcony person. Congratulations and thank you.
Bradford Michael Eschler, graduate 1970. Brad completed his education at John F. Kennedy High School, went on to the University of Michigan, received a degree in pharmacy, also received a degree in dentistry, and went on to join the United States Air Force. Brad is the married and a proud father of two. We present to you Bradford Eschler.
It's been said that bad news sells a lot of newspapers. And it also keeps the lights on and the bills paid at the cable news network. As a culture, it sometimes seems that we're obsessed with the negatives in our world. And this week has certainly been no exception. Unemployment is on the rise. The economy is in the pits. The recession is bound to be long and the recovery slow and difficult. In addition, every level of government is beset by money woes, and it seems that we'll not have the money in the future to pay our own way. We're having difficulties with the Soviets concluding a summit deal. Our allies are refusing to pay their own way. I can't deny that the news is bad, but take yourself back 21 years to the day when my classmates and I were sitting in your same seats. At that time, the United States was embroiled in a bloody and unpopular war in Vietnam. Many of us received our draft notices the following week after we graduated. The Cold War was at its height. Every day, the United States faced the Soviet Union across the abyss of nuclear destruction. America was not the preeminent, respected power that it is today, but was hated and feared around the world. Many Americans were called ugly. In the 60s, assassinated politicians bore the names Kennedy and King rather than Gandhi and Aquino. These men were assassinated in places like Dallas and Los Angeles, not India and Manila. We are shocked today by the brutality of drug-related crimes, but let us not forget the volcano of racial violence that erupted right here in Detroit in the late 60s. Then, as now, as graduates, we face an uncertain future. The environmental crisis was with us then too, but the difference was no one was recognizing it as such. No one was doing anything about it. I do not raise these dark issues on this happy occasion to cast a shadow over this ceremony or your accomplishment, but to remind you that everyone faces uncertainty and problems in their future. My own assessment is that things are a little better in general since I graduated from high school, although I can't deny that some things are somewhat worse. I like to think that some of the things that people of my generation in my class year have done have made the world a little better place to live in. And I am confident that you and your classmates can make the world as it is now a better place in the future. With your graduation, you are taking a confident first step into an interesting future. Do not doubt that you have been made more capable by your experiences at John F. Kennedy High School. As proof of the abilities of your generation to deal with an uncertain world, I would offer the performance of our troops in the recent Gulf War as a shining example of what Americans, many of them recent high school graduates, can accomplish. From Riyadh to Jerusalem, from Kurdistan to Ethiopia, wherever there's a Patriot missile battery to be manned or relief supplies to be delivered, the world now depends upon your energy and confidence. That confidence and the pride that you feel in yourself should be turned up a notch today. It is true that bad news may sell newspapers, but it is good people such as yourselves, confident people, capable people, who will do the world's work and solve the world's problems. Class of 91, I salute you.
Thank you, Mary and Brad. And somewhere down the road, I'm sure we will have inductees from the class of 91. Mr. Cackley, President of the Board of Education, please come forward. Mr. Cackley, members of the class of 1991 have completed all requirements for graduation as set forth by the Taylor Board of Education and the State of Michigan. On behalf of the faculty and the administration at Kennedy High School, I am very proud and pleased to present to you the commencement class of 91 of John F. Kennedy High School. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Bargamian. It's my privilege to congratulate the 1991 senior class of John F. Kennedy High School on behalf of the Board of Education. Each of you have completed all the requirements for graduation as established by the Taylor School District Board of Education. And so now, by the authority granted to me by my office and by the Michigan Department of Education, it is my pleasure to confer to each of you your diplomas and the title Graduate of John F. Kennedy High School. Congratulations.
Roderick Stewart Kerr, Jr. Deborah Marie Salwoski.
Nicole Renee Wilburn.
Stacy Renee Carnes.
Jennifer Marie Hoffman.
Michelle Lynn Bowers.
Sandra Johnson.
Patricia Ann McMahon.
Christy Ann Plan.
Robin Michelle Myers.
Angela Rochelle Painter.
Parents, may we indulge your cooperation if you would please clear the aisleway so that the graduates may come to the podium and to the stage, and everyone then can see. If you would like to pose for pictures immediately after the commencement ceremony, you're welcome to do that. And I guess I need to tell you that each of you will receive a photograph at your home through the mail of your graduate receiving his or her diploma. So if you would, please. Thank you.
Sean Adair.
Heather Ida Mueller.
Angela V. Afedian.
Bill David Elliott.
Amy Ann Ahonen.
Jennifer Lynn Elmore.
Ryan Todd Akers.
Stacy Carol Field.
Robert Keith Alanskis.
Jennifer Lynn Field.
Catherine A. Amadeo.
Timothy G. Francis.
Jennifer Lynn Andrews.
Matthew Frazier.
James Edward Arnold.
Ed Frazier.
And Jeanette Lynn Ashby.
Robert Edward Drew.
Elaine Babinski.
Karen Gagnon.
Jennifer Lynn Baker.
Dana Galley.
Katie Jo Ball.
Martha Garcia.
Dale Edward Barkoviak.
Marty Garcia.
Todd William Baum.
Leo Gervasi.
Rochelle Denise Benson.
Brian Joseph Gondek.
Rebecca Elizabeth Betts.
Tammy Sue Gordon.
Michelle Binder.
Scott Franz Gottfried.
Tricia Renee Boschel.
Shelly Lynn Graff.
Jim Bowman.
Dina Marie Graham.
Catherine Ann Bradley.
Jennifer Renee Greiser.
Patrick Glenn Brazidas.
James Leon Greigel.
Angela Sue Browning.
Keith William Harris.
Ronald Brueger.
Jack H. Hart.
Crystal Renee Buckner.
Tyree Haskin.
Lisa Dawn Busey.
Stephanie Havman.
Stephen Glenn Cade.
Deborah Ann Hawkins.
Kevin Caldwell. Jermaine David Cameron.
Lisa Heberlin.
Jason James Campbell.
Jennifer Ann Kermistor.
Dennis William Tan.
Tamara Renee Hilliker.
Daniel Sahanowitz.
Jacqueline Hirsch.
Richard Allen Klingerman.
Linda Ray Hogan.
Jimmy Lee Clinton.
Joanne Howells.
Michael Scott Clipper.
Lynn Marie Ivy.
Gina Coffey. Victoria Cook.
Belinda Nell Jackson.
Anna Cortez.
Ann Margaret Joaquin.
Douglas Dean Couser.
Christy Michelle Johnson.
Desiree Lenore Cox.
Lori Michelle Jones.
David A. Kraft.
Christopher Lee Joseph.
Valerio Chris.
Brian Kelsick. John Thomas Kaminsky.
Wayne David Cuthbert.
Michelle Christina Keene.
Michelle Daly.
Amy Melissa Kelm.
Kenneth R. Dandy.
Brenda Marie Kennedy.
Quadraline Lamone Daniel.
Jared Klein.
Dean J. Garin.
Amy Koloszynski.
Mark Scott Doherty.
Amy Susan Konarski.
Nicole Marie DeBlock.
Karen Renee Kozlowski.
Angela Marie Dion.
Jeffrey Robb.
John Stephen Desi.
Kenneth Michael Rosen.
Lorraine Renee Diamond.
Lisa Susan Ruiz.
David S. Dobbs.
Tina Lynette Seaton.
Jeffrey Michael Duda.
Raquel Lynn Schob.
Edward Joseph Dupy III.
Michael Sias.
Sarah Lynette Dwarzynski.
Scott Siebel.
Joseph Curtis Lambert.
Christopher Stewart.
Tara LaDonna Lambert.
Jeff Stewart.
Thomas J. LaDuke.
James Strauss.
Robin K. Levy. Catherine Marie Laurie.
Bridget Ann Sugg.
Susan Marie Lipinski.
Jesse Allen Southern.
Raymond Alex Manchin.
Raleigh Ellen Carey.
George William Otosco Jr.
Bradley Arthur Thiessen.
Vincent Michael Mailer.
Sonia Ann Thompson.
Dahl William Mallory.
Sharissa Marie Till.
James Chester Marshallitis.
Andrea K. Toller.
James Edward Markham.
Jennifer Lynn Krasinski.
Jenny Lynn Martin.
Mildred Juanita Tuck.
Vaughn Christopher Martin. Martinez.
Carla Marie Barton.
Sarah Beth Mason. Philip J. McDonald.
Tammy Warren.
Rilly Welch McGuire III.
Tracy Lynn Welch.
John Harlan Merkel. James Edwin Hessel. Susan Penelope Mezzel.
Stephen Michael Whitby.
Brian David Miller.
Derek Wilder.
Stephen Clyde Miller. Danielle S. Mitchell.
Ronald Lee White.
Keith Allen Mooney. Shannon Marie Moore.
Nicole Marie Yack.
Carmen Donata Morris.
Jody Lynn Yike.
Robin Marie Morrow.
Matthew James Abadell.
Jennifer Marie Mulligan. Amy Christine Murray.
Linda Michelle Volk.
Kim Nettle.
William Edward Cruz.
Teresa Marie Nestor.
Jack Reed.
Michael Anthony Neville. Victor J. New.
Randy Anthony Priester.
Randall Lee Nightingale.
Jason Lee Prim.
Nicole Nixon.
Mark Stephen Ragsdale.
Robert Stephen Oliver. Michelle Renee Ordway.
Josie Randazzo.
Michelle S. Overby. Jason Peaks.
Daniel Reeves.
Ronald Vincent A. Pereira. Terry Lee Peters.
Christy Ann Richards.
Brian Allen Pfeiffer.
Brian Donald Ringett.
Mark Jason Pinchett. Christina C. Pollington. Donna Potter. Cinnamon Renee Powell.
Father, we thank you for the capacity you've given us to learn. Thank you so much for the ability to apply the things we've learned. As we reflect back over our kindergarten years, our elementary, our junior high, and our high school, may we be appreciative of the teachers who gave us this fine education. Lord, I've asked that you give us the desire, the determination, the discipline to go from this place, to apply the things we've learned, and Father, to change this world. Lord, even though that we do not know what the future holds for all of us, we would ask, Lord, that you would help us to understand that we do know who holds the future. Thank you for this wonderful occasion. Father, we appreciate these graduates and pray that you'll take them safely into their futures, and may they do great things. In your name we ask all of this. Amen.